So what we're going to look at now is just to give you an idea about the general kind of landscape of search ads. So these are the, you know, the wee ads that appear at the top of Google, Bing, Yahoo, all of that sort of stuff, and down the sides. Just going to give you a quick overview of that, because a lot of the principles within the text ads are replicated through display and all the other ones that we're going to look at today. So search engine marketing is the process of placing pay-per-click ads in search engine results pages. Does everybody know what I mean by pay-per-click? Somebody clicks on your ad, the advertiser pays for it. Who in the room clicks on these things? One person. Right, I should have put a caveat in this. We'll pretend that this didn't happen. I make a living, right, from people clicking on these ads for my clients. Now, can I ask you who clicks on these ads? I have two kids, one on the way, need the money. So one person out of, what do we reckon we've got here, 40, 50 people? We're slightly, Ballymena was miles ahead. You could tell the difference. You're way below average. Probably 30 to 40% of people in the UK and Ireland will click on these ads. It's probably higher kind of England, Scotland, Wales than it is over here at the minute, to be honest. But then it's probably because a lot of, you know, a lot of our businesses, we take that wee bit longer to do things. We are a bit more cautious in Northern Ireland. I think that's fair to say. Okay, so there's loads of different reasons why people won't click on these things. And despite the fact that, as I say, I make a living out of them, not everybody does. Only about 30 to 40% of people actually will. Now, it is increasing, which is good. But the biggest reason that most people will come back to or back with whenever we ask them why they don't is generally, does anybody ever find them irrelevant? The ads aren't relevant to what you've looked for in the first place. Hands up for irrelevance. Okay. Google absolutely knows this and understands where you're coming from. So Google's biggest thing, it used to be, they used to try to promote websites that had great reach, ranked highly, and were highly relevant. They've now gone down the line if they just want to promote relevance. So if you type in looking for wine glasses, you'll see ads for wine glasses. You'll click on a page that then tries to sell you some wine glasses. It's pretty relevant. Unfortunately, this market is full of people who, if you type in wine glasses, you'll see Debenhams trying to sell you a dressing gown. It's just, it's done badly. So a lot of people have kind of got snowblind to the fact that, oh, I'm not even going to bother clicking those things because they're not relevant. Now, Google are actively promoting companies, whether you're doing it yourself, you're doing it through an agency or whatever it is, that if you do this more relevantly and give the user the right results back, they will charge you less. It's not always the person that pays the most goes to the top. It most certainly isn't that. We had one of our clients before Christmas competes in the designer clothing kind of market, and he absolutely wiped the floor with House of Fraser, Debenhams, John Lewis and everything, pound for pound, because he did things right. If somebody went on and looked for, I'm going to start rhyming off loads of designer names now, a Tommy Hilfiger main down coat in red, size medium, he had an ad sitting up there for exactly that. What House of Fraser would have done was they would have had an ad for coats, and then you arrive in and you go, that's not what I asked for. It's essentially like, does anybody own a bricks and mortar retail store or a working one? Nobody does. Death of the high streets. What does it do? Okay, so say somebody walked into your place and said, I want a pair of toe-tack, do they still exist? Toe-tack boots? Yeah. My dad always wore them, he's an electrician. So somebody walks into your shop and says, I'd like a pair of toe-tack boots in a size 8. What do? You take them straight to the product, exactly what it is. What you don't do is somebody walks in and says, can I get a pair of toe-tack boots size 8? You go, they're over there somewhere. You don't do that. But everybody does it online. If you do it relevantly, all of a sudden you'll have people will actually be clicking on these ads. But not only that, Google will reward you and they'll charge you a powerful amount less. So the amount of people clicking on these things is increasing, thank goodness. And it's solely because people are doing things properly. So pay-per-click itself is an advertising service. It's entirely advertiser-led. So going back, if you don't mind me using yours as the example, every day we get clients saying, you know, that have been running AdWords with somebody else or whatever, and they'll come to us and go, oh, AdWords doesn't work. I'm so skeptical. No. AdWords does work. I can show you 50, 60 AdWords accounts that are absolutely kicking the backside off things at the minute. The reason why it works is it's led by you guys. You pick your budget. You pick your audience. You pick what product you want to sell. You pick what time of day you want your ads to appear, what keywords want to trigger these ads, and then Google displays the winning ad. So see all the stuff that makes things not work? Unfortunately, it's down to you guys. You make the decisions here. So if there's something not working, it's because you're not doing it properly. And what I'll hopefully get round to is kind of showing you some of the mistakes that people do make. So Google displays the winning ad. What makes up a winning ad? Anyone? Relevance is key. What else? How else do you get to the top? You've just set up an ads campaign. How do you get up there where you want to be? So you want to be relevant for a start. Biggest common misconception that there is with AdWords is you have to pay through the nose to be at the top. nothing to do with that. So it's essentially relevance. That's it. Just be relevant to what Google are doing. Price does come into it to a degree, but it's not the be-all and end-all. You do not categorically have to pay the most to be number one. Nowhere near it. We have ads running for a lot of our clients that if you offer relevance, it goes in a measurement called quality score, which is a measurement out of 10 to how relevant the keyword is to the ad and then to the landing page. We have clients paying a tenth of what their competitors are paying, and they're still sitting in number one position because they're doing it properly. Okay, so Google displays the winning ad. That's the one that basically is the most relevant, has the highest what is known as ad rank. And a couple of things will depend on that. Quality score, which is just explained as a measurement out of 10 based on the relevance of the keyword to the ad copy to the landing page. Obviously, the more relevant, the better. And it also depends on other advertisers. This is where cost does come in. So you can have people absolutely throwing money at this sort of stuff. You'll generally find they'll have a little peak for a while, and then it'll fall to pieces for them. The people that throw money at these things don't consider the return on investment of a keyword. They don't say, right, if I get 10 clicks and they cost me a tenner each, that's 100 quid. I'm selling a product that only costs 50. Doesn't make any sense. People, whenever they're putting bids on keywords, they don't consider the return on investment from their product. They just kind of go, Google suggested a quid, so I better do that. Google makes suggestions based on people not having the first clue what they do. So whenever you set up an AdWords campaign, one of the first things you'll do is keyword research. So you'll say you're doing, is it rent software? What would you call it, sort of? Rental management software. So you go onto the Google Keyword Planner, which I'll show you in a second, and you type in rental management software, and it'll tell you how many clicks are available in the period of time, on average in a month and in the area that you've decided to look at, and it'll give you a suggested bid. The suggested bid is the amount that they suggest you pay or are happy to pay every time somebody clicks on one of the ads. The biggest mistake that everybody makes is they believe Google. What you have to remember, this market is full of people that haven't a clue what they're doing, unfortunately. Google AdWords is a bloody difficult thing to do. So by not knowing what you're doing, you agree with Google and you go, yeah, that should be a pound, absolutely. We run a campaign for a big candle brand and we were suggested that we should be paying in the region, I think it was a pound for the term, for the brand term. We get it for 11p because we do our job properly. That's where what you're doing can be achieved a lot better. Give the user exactly what they want and try to second guess it or mass market a market that isn't there and you'll save a lot of money. So you don't listen to Google. They weirdly, they make a lot of money from this, $72 billion in the US last year, just from people clicking these ads.